4 weeks away from Christmas, and if you want to give a gift that is a little different this time of year, why not cook a special something? The wonderful Julie Goodwin is here with us in the kitchen with a gift idea that's not just a great present but also incredibly tasty. Julie, we love you. Good morning.
Good morning. Yes. Thank you for having us.
This is such a great idea because also when you cook something, it's extra special, isn't
it? It's from the heart, isn't it? And this is one in particular that you can do at Christmas time. I mean, mangoes are, they're the smell of Christmas. They're the smell of summer.
So yummy.
And so the best thing about them is buying just a box load, eating as many as you can, and then using the rest to make this. So it's to make curried mango chutney. So
that's ginger?
A little bit of ginger.
So you're making chutney.
That's not a little bit. A little bit. No, yeah. It's not a little bit. It's quite a lot, isn't it? But we love ginger.
I love ginger. I just love eating it. It's so good.
All these beautiful aromas.
We got a little bit of garlic.
Garlic and some capsicum. I'm just going to
sauté
that. And then a little bit of sambal oleic, which is crushed chilies. You can just chop up fresh chilies if you prefer.
All that.
Wow. Now, when you cook all this up and everything, how many jars will you make at a time, you think?
This batch, this batch will make 3 to 4 jars. But
one
when
for each
I,
of us, yes.
When,
okay.
Yeah, when I cook it, I make it in vats. So every Christmas we do this and, you know, friends and family get a jar. And, it just does.
And Julie, can I just show everyone these incredible labels? Oh. You made them. Which camera? This one? There we go. These are, now, you actually drew this and then you took a photo on your phone and then sent it to your computer and printed it out.
Yeah. So I think it's nice to personalise it. So.
And then you can put their name on it.
Yeah, that's right.
Up the top.
I love that you actually drew this.
That is
so beautiful. I mean, you're an artist as well. What don't you do, Julie Goodwin?
Well, it's a nice way to while away the time while you're watching and Studio 10 on the telly.
And where do you buy the label?
Oh, that's just from like Officeworks or anywhere like that.
They're just
labels.
But I want to know about these. Natural food saver sheets, fresh paper.
This is new, Denise, and I can't even tell you. I've only had it for a couple of weeks, but you just put a sheet, so they're infused. It's paper infused. Have a smell. Like with organic herbs and spices. You pop it in your fruit bowl, in your fridge crisper, and it at least doubles the life of
your
fruit and veggies.
No way.
Wow. Not kidding at all.
Where do you get those from?
So you can get them at freshpaper.com .au. They're coming out in stores soon, in the lead up to Christmas, so please keep an eye out because that will save so much waste.
How are we doing this?
We're doing good, and what we're going to do now...
And, Julie, while you're cooking, I need to ask you a question because on the news the other day, we ran CCTV vision, I think we've got it, of someone stealing pot plants from your... Here it is. From your business. What was going on there?
I don't know.
I know plants are expensive, but that's ridiculous.
Well, the funny thing was we went to look at the marketplace and the, you know, gum tree to see who might be selling them, and so many people are giving them away for free.
You're kidding.
Don't know why anybody pinched them.
Did the police get them?
They did. A couple of days later, some plainclothes cops came down with my little pot plants in their hands.
Crime solved.
What's that there?
So I've got pineapple juice here.
There we go.
And a bit of white vinegar. So, you know, a chutney's got to have a bit
of vinegar.
Sour element to it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Curry powder, so hot
there
curry powder.
There we go. Oh, I can smell that.
We've got brown sugar.
Julie, do you put lemon and vinegar when you cook a curry?
Oh, I can do, yeah. Curry will sometimes have a vinegar in it or something sour or tamarind or lime juice.
Oh, I love tamarind.
It's got to have something sour in it, yeah, definitely.
And how long do you have to cook this up for?
You cook that for about, I don't know, 40 minutes.
Till it gets to look like this.
And then it'll look like that.
It's one we prepared earlier.
Now, I want to tell you really, you cook. I just want to ask, you're doing radio now and you're up at 4 a.m. What, you do everything.
I am, I'm on Star 104.5 up the Central Coast.
Oh.
And that's 5 days a week and I love it.
You love it?
I love it so much fun. I get to just turn up and have a chat and have a laugh and it's so good. But I want to show you this tip about how to get mango out.
I was just about to ask that.
Now, I was told this, you do also get that flesh off there, but this is the really tricky one. Someone who came to my cooking school showed me this. You just get a glass. So I'd always done the dicing, the turn it inside out. Get a glass.
I've seen this somewhere else.
And do it like that, so you don't waste any on the skin.
It comes out like that.
Can I try that?
Isn't that
great?
You have a go. Yeah, I took that out.
Now, Julie, aside from cooking the chutney, the next thing that we've got to learn is how to bottle it.
How to bottle it.
Because that's really important.
Well, I'd love to show you that. Can we swap those pots around?
Oh, yeah. It is so easy.
It's good, isn't it? This looks just like a bought one, you two. All right, so this is a jam funnel.
I've never seen one of those.
You just get them at homeware stores.
Okay.
You can do it without, but you might get into a little bit of a mess. You're going there.
I'm taking us
a little bit of a mess.
Segment.
There you go. Oh, look at that.
Well done.
How great is that?
Mangoes are expensive, so this way you use every little bit.
No, they're not at the moment if you shop around.
They're in season.
Okay, Denise.
So what you do, for this to be sterile, so you've jars in the oven for 10 minutes with the lids off, you boil up the lids, just give it a little tap so that all the air's taken up. Move
there
that onto
you
your next jar.
She's brilliant.
Lid on. And of course,
it smells delicious.
A pretty little label.
That's awesome.
And away you go.
And you can
just go.
Yep. Julie, we love you. Thank you so much.
So good. Yeah.
Christmas sorted.
But we're going to go a quick break and then we're going to have a taste of this delicious chutney. We'll be back in just a moment. See you soon. Julie Goodwin's beautiful mango chutney, guys. Please.
Yeah, yeah, it's delicious.
Yummy. Can we have a little taste?
I've cheated.
You've already had a taste. Yeah, you couldn't wait. And he's such a perfect Christmas gift.
Oh, yeah.
We put the labels on, and look, here's Joe's. Look at that.
Because my mother always told me not to label people. But...
Oh, God.
Here we go. Look
and
at
I love
that.
It.
Look
at that. You design these.
Yeah. Oh, curry. Cold meats.
Cold meats.
On a sandwich. On a cheese platter. We've got nice, sharp cheese. On your burgers, on your sandwiches.
Oh, burgers.
Just eat it out of the jar.
Oh, you know what? Really be good if you had like just a nice chicken breast grilled and then had that on top with a nice little vegetable.
Absolutely.
Oh, I'm telling you.
Could I order the chicken breast grilled, please, but just lightly grilled?
Yeah.
And then some of the chutney.
Yep. Yes. I love it.
Did you want a whole wheat bun with that?
Yes, yes. Please.
Yes.
I'll get the rest of the orders.
Brioche bun.
And all of the details of Julie's recipe are on our website. That is template/studio10. Do not miss.